You are, you change the threat. bring your of the greatest hits, well, the first Samuel 8, Moses 3 says this, when Samuel grew old, he appointed his sons as judges for Israel. The name of his firstborn was Saul, the name of the second was Abiah, and they served up for Ziba. His son did not walk in his ways. They turned and died after Dishon, and there are many leaders in the Bible whose children did not grow up to follow the Lord. Adam had children. Peter was a great king, but he was a Catholic father. Jacob, his wife, and many others had a hard time passing on their faith. And that's true today as well. Sometimes the greatest spiritual leaders have children who choose to go. Sometimes that's the result of grown children using their own talents, starting with their own source. Sometimes it's the result of fathers who need that word as a leader in that home. If you want your kids to walk in these ways, it will require immense investment in them. It's not just the job to lead the kids. Literally, Ephesians 5:23 says, "For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, the husband of his body, of which he is the Savior." And many of that means that just as Christ leads the church, he's the head of the church, you lead your wife. Help them be the spiritual leaders of your home. But it's not up to your wife to go to the church on Sunday. It's not up to your wife to be the one, the only one that teaches your kids about Jesus. As the head of the family, it's up to you to set the tone and the direction. The responsibility is on you to focus on leading, not the leader. Joshua 24:15, Joshua made this great declaration. He said, he declared, "Choose for yourselves this day who you will serve, whether the gods your forefathers served throughout the desert, or the gods of the Israelites. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." The Joshua meant that great declaration. And some of you need that verse hanging on the wall somewhere in your home. It's a daily reminder. A daily reminder of who it is that we serve. It's not your wealth, it's not your hobby, it's your Lord. That's the whole verse that I have more of. That more for 120 years since he and the only saved eight people. Someone else rephrased that. He said, "No one spent 120 years preaching, but he saved the whole family." And many years today, they dropped and they had a house. And I see a lot of parents who are getting to mess with their kids or adults, and they tell me what they're concerned about their adult kids and how they left the faith or they're making poor decisions. And you may never have that satisfaction to say, "On what? You could have done everything right. The father you should have, and you always have. The kids, even if the kids are adults. And you may never get the results for your kids that you desire in your life, but remain faithful in leading them to your own. Influence in your own. Above anything else, God calls us to faithfulness. And you leave the results up to Him. And you just need to follow Jesus in your existence. God calls us to faithfulness. That's the number one thing. And you want all of us to do is to be faithful to Him, faithful to Christ, faithful to His responsibility. You need to be faithful. And the need for your death is Him. Now, the third fatherhood focus is this. Focus on legacy, not just your life. Focus on legacy, not just your life. Some people just want to live a good life. That's what they're in for. That's what they want to do. Every Jesus follower should want to build a legacy. A legacy outlasts your lifetime, basically. It outlasts years. A legacy is more than your personality. It's more than a list of successes. It's more than just a good life. A couple of weeks ago, here in this room, right off the stage, I had the honor of addressing our academy graduates. And they were all here. They took up both of these front rows here. And I was closing out the service. of the reality of their kingdom death. And as the first words out of our mouth were, one day, you will die. And it was this nervous, awkward chuckle that I came to the audience to know for the second time. We were expecting to reach for the stars, to dream big, but God doesn't ask us to do this one. It was part of this. Thank you.